Delaware Bay is, we are dying. Then you throw in wind farms, which we now know will, the electromagnetic field. That data was presented by the Recreational Fishing Alliance. Stunning presentation by them. They have done more research on the fishery, the ocean, and how wind farm electricity and salt water affects the migratory patterns of flounder. You couple it with all those things I mentioned before, there will be no flounder. They are not coming towards an electromagnetic field. We were told that they would migrate away from New Jersey. It is our cash crop. What is wrong with people? Do you hear a revolution? Yeah.
Got Victor from Linwood on the line. Victor, what do you got? What do you got on your mind?
It's kind of sad, though. You go to these shows, and a lot of people are just selling all their stuff because they don't want to fish no more.
Oh, baby.
I mean, that's proof right there that something's wrong.
There you go. That's what we've been saying.
I see it firsthand. People are just getting rid of everything they have because they've given up. Well, the fish are going further offshore. They're just not coming in. There's no habitat here.
That's... Rocco from Brigantine, you've been hanging in there.
Hey there, Shep. Hey there, Robin. Hey.
Good morning.
Bill.
Morning.
I wanted to make sure that you all know that that company called Orsted, they are one of the companies that want to build that forest of wind turbines off our coast. They are ramping up the PR machine. From what I see from this company called Orsted, who wants to get taxpayer subsidy to build this forest of wind turbines off the coast, we're looking at maybe 10 miles off the coast. That means we can see this forest Absolutely. Right from the beach.
Mm-hmm.
Now, not only is this incredibly risky for the taxpayers, the ROI, but marine life as well. Just like Robin said, that electromagnetic waves that will be emanating coming off those undersea cables, that's really bad for the fishery and the migration of our fish. In New Jersey, the number two industry is fishing and wildlife and agriculture. Why are we destroying one of our greatest assets? We're looking at industrializing our coast, whether it's man-made dunes we don't need or it's outfall sewer pipes along our beaches. And now we're considering using taxpayer money, giving it to a company, possibly a company called Orsted, to build a forest of wind turbines off the Jersey coast. No, thank you.
All three of the organizations that have been given permits are from Europe.
And the tax abatements, as I understand, expire in year 2022, which is why the rush. But you are brilliant because a picture just flashed in my mind. I spent a couple years living in Southern California. And all I have to do is get a picture of the oil well in the harbor at Long Beach and put it here because people will then get the idea what they're going to be looking at.
For the most part, we like to see a reduction in fossil fuels, but we got to be smarter about how we use our natural resources, especially in Jersey. Why are we industrializing our greatest assets?
But for every kilowatt hour of wind farm energy produced, it requires 1 kilowatt hour of gas to produce it. We're not reducing fossil fuels.
Thank you very much, everybody. Have a great Saturday.
Cool.
Have a good
Thank you, Rocco.
There's going to be less habitat when they start putting the windmills up.
Yep.
Is this Captain Bob?
Hey, Shep. What's going
up?
On, buddy?
How you
hey,
doing,
Robin,
big guy?
One thing I'm firing up about is the forest that's going to go off of our
that's
coast
amazing,
here.
Isn't it?
That windmill forest that's going to go up here, over 500 and some odd windmills, they're saying. It's going to go off in New Jersey from New York down to Cape May. Now I don't know about you, but I don't want to see a forest off our
Me
coast.
Either.
Well, at a meeting I was at Wednesday night,
which
was a dog and pony show,
mm-hmm.
Ocean County up there, actually one of the representatives actually said, we have to build it to find out exactly what it's going to do to us. And I said, is Nancy Pelosi in the room?
Yeah.
That's what it sounds like. They did a study of what, five of them, which is toothpicks, compared to 500,
right.
which is going to go off our coast.
And
5 to 500, that's a big difference there. And they can't give us any kind of outcome, any kind of science, any kind of data, except it's better than sliced bread. And we need it.
And the ones going off our coast are going to be twice as big as the ones off of Rhode Island.
Correct.
And there's bigger ones on the horizon. They're like 600 to 800 feet in the air.
Yikes.
They can go up to 1,000. What I don't understand is where are the so-called environmentalists, conservationists, bird people, and all that now. I do understand that the rush to throw this thing out there is because of the tax abatements, I guess, expire in 2022. Is that correct, Bill? That's why we're being kind of railroaded with this.
Yes.
But it is to serve the profit for some and annihilating the fishery with the state. So I don't even think we should be entertaining it at this stage of the game. If it were any other thing, like trying to get a slot fish in here, geez, it takes us years. But if you're going to put a 500-member forest off the ocean, let's just do it and find out what happens. So,
well, here's the other thing, Robin, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Every company that sat at the table Wednesday night in Ocean County and everyone that's been at the meetings coming up, guess where they're all from?
Europe. They're all from Europe.
Not one of them is from the United States. And guess who's taking advantage of our tax dollars?
Yeah.
Foreign companies.
Amazing.
Well, that's because they can't build anymore over in Europe because it's failing. So they'll come over here.
Germany's rebuilding their coal plants. I know you heard that one.
Yep.
Because they don't work. The wind doesn't blow all the time. It's just that simple. That's why they have to go higher and higher and higher to try to catch more wind.
The problem is we've got a governor who's set on putting windmills off our shore. He obviously doesn't fish.
I heard him say it before he got elected. He wants to make our state the California of the East Coast.
You got it. He's doing a good job.
And everybody sees what's happening in California. They're broke.
Yep.
Everybody wants out of California. There's mass exodus of people moving out of California.
Yep.
They don't want to be there. And they're who wants to live in California now?
The school systems are second to Mississippi at the bottom of the barrel as far as the quality of education. Now, California, I happen to have spent a couple years in Southern California, Bob, and the wind farms out there are all on land.
Yeah.
And there's thousands of them, and they're beautiful, and they work. You cannot compare them to putting them out in the ocean. There aren't any fish in the Joshua Tree National Forest. It just doesn't work that way.
They have a parkway running up and down our coast. Why can't they put them in the middle of the parkway or do something of that nature?
Yeah.
That's a good idea.
They haven't even thought about that.
That's a good idea, though.
Yep.
All right.
You know, so it's the new Green Deal. What do you want? Oh, I went there. Sorry.
I always love your candor. So what do we do?
Listen, we got to get on this. We got to call politicians. We got to call... Congressman Van Drew. It's not Senator anymore. It's Congressman Van Drew. We have to get a hold of Pallone, who is on the Energy Committee.
Okay.
We get a hold of him. We start attacking him and tell him.
I'll call.
We don't want this.
Very cool. It's good.
They should each have an aide appointed to do nothing other than work on this issue now.
Well, the worst part about this, too, is the DEP said it the other night, Fish and Game Council meeting. They're spending so many man hours on wind energy right now that they're not spending man hours on fish stocks.
Yeah.
And that is very disheartening. We're spending money on something that may or may not work, that is being jammed down our throats. We're paying for it. And they don't have any science, they don't have any data, they don't have any support, they don't have any feedback, they don't have any plan B options for us, they have nothing. They have nothing except it's better than sliced bread and we're going full force ahead.